Hi, this is Terry Bergen with The Entertainers and Real Time. Today I'm talking with editor of Mamma Mia. It's Jamila Rizvi. Did I get that right?
That's right. Okay. Exactly how it's spelled.
So I guess the best place for us to start, Jamila, is to ask you to give us a brief snapshot of who you are and perhaps a little bit of your journey up to this point in time.
Yeah, of course. So I am a Canberra girl, born and bred, which is, we're a very rare breed. Canberrans who stay, but that means that I am incredibly interested in politics and public service. That's always been a real passion of mine, and that's ended up putting me in journalism, which was an interesting path. I studied at the ANU and studied commerce and law, where I was the student president and sort of got very used to being very bossy, outspoken and in charge, and discovered that's what I quite liked.
Yeah.
And I worked for Prime Minister Kevin Rudd for about a year straight out of uni, and then moved on to working for Minister Kate Ellis in a variety of roles, and I worked for her in women's policy, in youth policy, which are areas I'm really passionate about, and then went on to be her chief of staff and media advisor. Then I got poached by Mia, realised that politics perhaps wasn't as fun as working for the biggest women's website in the country, and I've moved over to Sydney and am spending a lot more time, I suppose, getting out and talking about the things that make me really excited, which tends to be things like women's issues, politics, but a little bit of everything. The best thing about Mamma Mia is our brief is what everyone's talking about today, which is the best brief you could possibly come up with.
Absolutely.
So whatever's interesting and whatever people are interested in at that moment in time, that's my job.
Whatever's trending.
Exactly, which is pretty exciting.
Right.
So I'm not a someone who talks around the issues, and I don't beat around the bush at all. I like to give my opinion and put it pretty firmly, but I think above everything, I'm a real people person. I'm interested in people and interested in what makes people tick and what makes them think certain things and behave in certain ways. And I think that's why I've come to work so much in public speaking and websites and journalism, is that so much of that is about understanding other people and getting to know other people. So I am very much outspoken. I like to laugh. And I love to have a good debate, a good feisty debate. I think first and foremost is sort of women in middle and senior management and women around the boardroom table. Australia is still absolutely woeful when it comes to women being senior in business. I think we're something about 8% of boards in the country, ASX top 200 boards, have women on them.
Yeah.
That is disgusting.
It is.
And there's so much debate there about how we can do better, whether or not we need to be looking to quotas, whether we need to look to incentives. But certainly Australia is missing out on a huge amount of its capabilities. Women taking their place, not just in the business world, but also in the political world, and women's representation in parliament and ability to participate in the workplace and in public life is still somewhere where Australia's got a long way to go. I really like having the chance to hear from different people's perspectives, and I really enjoy spending some time when I'm going to be working with an organisation talking about who's in that room, because so many speakers go into a speaking gig thinking about what they want to say and not what the audience is looking to hear. So I really like looking at something and saying, if I was in that audience, what would I learn? What would push me? What would make me think about something in a different way? What would make me laugh? What would make me cry? As opposed to going in there and just pushing what I'm about. I really enjoyed the facilitation side. I manage a team of 12 here at Mamma Mia, and making sure everyone's opinion gets heard and making sure everyone gets a go.